Hello students, welcome to Easy Biology Tutorials. In the last class, we basically discussed about the species competitions. Now we are going to start from the third kind of interaction, that is parasitism. तो हम parasitism से start करने वाले हैं. Many parasites are host specific, that is they can parasitize only a single host species. They tend to co-evolve. ठीक है, तो जैसे अगर कोई host, जैसे lice and human being, lice attacks human being, lice attacks other mammals also. तो जैसे जैसे mammals evolve होंगे वैसे वैसे जो lice है वो भी क्या हो जाएगी, evolve हो जाएगी. Co-evolution का मतलब क्या होता है, co-evolution evolution that take place equally in the organisms. For example, if a host evolves special mechanisms against the parasite, the parasite also evolves mechanism to counteract them to remain with the same host. So this is the thing. Okay, so this is known as a co-evolution between the parasites and the host. Next is parasitism, adaptation of parasites. First of all, loss of sense organs. Parasites ke andar kisi bhi type ke sense organs nahi hote hain. This is very very important. This is a star question. ये आता ही होता है कि what are the adaptations to parasitisms. First of all is parasites lose the sense organs. उनके पास adhesive organs होते हैं so that they can get attached to the host in one or the other way, जिससे वो remove नहीं होते easily. आपने कभी भी देखा होगा parasites को, अगर वो ectoparasites हैं, ectoparasites के केस में parasites are very very difficult to remove, वो remove नहीं होते हैं. Next is they are not having digestive system because they are sucking the blood. चाहे ectoparasites हैं हमारे पास, चाहे endoparasites हैं, they are not having any kind of digestive system because they don't need it. Okay, why don't they need it? Because उनके पास तो they are having a mechanism जिसके through वो direct blood को suck कर सकते हैं. Direct blood को suck करने के बाद वो nutrients ले सकते हैं. So there is no loss of there is no use of a digestive system. तो ये बिल्कुल direct proteins, carbohydrates, fats को ही absorb कर रहे हैं और खुद को grow कर रहे हैं. तो digestive system में हम बोल सकते हैं कि energy waste करने का क्या फायदा. इसलिए all the parasites either they are irrespective of the kingdom, class, phylum they are belonging, they do not have a digestive system. All the parasites are having high reproductive capability. Either they are reproducing asexually or they are reproducing sexually. They are having a very very high reproductive capacity. Yes. Next is life cycle of parasites are often complex. For example, human liver fluke depends on two intermediate hosts, that is a snail and a fish, to complete its life cycle. This is a very very important question. जो human liver fluke है उसके दो host होते हैं, जो malarial parasite है उसके भी दो host होते हैं. ठीक है, एंड वी आर हैविंग अदर काइंड ऑफ पैरासाइट्स आल्सो जिसके जिसके पास दो होस्ट होते हैं. सो मलेरियल पैरासाइट नीड्स मॉस्किटो टू स्प्रेड टू देयर अदर होस्ट, सो दे आर आल्सो हैविंग टू होस्ट. नेक्स्ट इज पैरासाइट्स का मेन फंक्शन क्या होता है, So the main characteristics of parasites are that the parasites harm the host, they reduce the survival, population density, growth and reproduction of the host, they make the host physically weak and more vulnerable to the predation, and so in this way. There are two types of parasites, the ectoparasites and the endoparasites. Ectoparasites ke andar hai human lice, ticks on dogs. Endoparasites ke andar we are having roundworm, tapeworm and liver fluke. Next is ectoparasites. In detail about the description of the ectoparasites. For example, lice on human, ticks on dogs. Ectoparasites copoids in many marine fishes. Cascata plants on the hedge plants. It has no chlorophyll and leaves. It derives nutrition from the host plant. So Cascata plant is a partial parasite. Why partial? Because it is derived. It is not a basically Cascata plant is a fully parasite because वो habitat के लिए भी dependent हो रहा है, photosynthesis के लिए भी depend हो रहा है. कई plants जो होते हैं वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ habitat के लिए dependent होते हैं, कई plants होते हैं सिर्फ और सिर्फ photosynthesis के लिए. Phoebe mosquito is not considered a parasite because it needs our blood only for reproduction and not as food. So mosquitoes are not considered as parasite, but they of course they do bother us. So this is the thing. Next we are having the endoparasites, parasites that live inside the host body at different sites, for example liver, kidney, lungs, RBC, etc. The life cycle of endoparasites are more complex. They have simple morphological and anatomical features and high reproductive potential. So endoparasites ke andar bahut zyada reproductive potential hota hai.